Hi, I'm Koral Dasgupta, author of Russia, and today, as you can see, I'm sitting with Komalika Ghotagupta, and I'm sure I don't have to introduce her, but anyway, other than being an actor, she is an excellent dancer, and not just a dancer, she has a very active dance academy in Mumbai, and I have often wondered that how come you have restricted your dance academy only to Mumbai? There must be students from across states who would want to be your student.
But you know, as they say, one step at a time. So I came to Bombay to be an actor, and for the next maybe 10 years or so, I just concentrated on getting a foothold in the television industry, and that is tough to say the least, because that was also a time when I stepped in, was also a time when the television industry was also emerging, and it was definitely not what it is today. So I have to put in a lot of effort, and it took a lot of time also to find a footing in the industry. But always in the back of my mind, it was there that I wanted to reconnect with my Bengali culture, because I've been born and bred and brought up in a family totally into music and dance. And so from the time that I've known forever, actually, I've been learning Rabindranath, folk music, and been a part of many, many performances. So I missed that when I was in Bombay. So it was always in the back of my mind that whenever I get the time, get a leave, I'm going to get back to that in some way. So Srijan is actually that dream coming true. And so I knew that there are many Bengalis here, and they always want to reconnect with their roots again. So with Srijan, I tried to provide a platform for all Bengalis to learn Rabindranath and Rabindranath here. So, and also what has happened is, you know, most of our children, like I have two daughters, they do not learn Bangla in school, obviously. So they don't know how to read and write Bangla. But even through this music, they are at least getting to know the language. So I think that that's
and a large part of the culture.
Yes, a large part of the culture, yes.
Komalika, in my story, the hero, the protagonist, Rajshekhar Subramanian, he is a dancer. He's a Bharatanatyam dancer, and he has floated his dance academy in India, and now he is ambitious to take it abroad. I wanted to ask you, I mean, what I have weaved is fiction. I wanted to ask some real-life experiences from you. What happens, what is an artist's ambition? I mean, ambition is something which traditionally we link very much with the corporate, but now thankfully things are pretty different. Art also has its ambition, even before it had, but the ambition of art is very different from the ambition otherwise.
Correct. How would you think the ambition of an artist, any artist, you know, across the form, is to be seen and acknowledged. I feel that even if you're learning Gaan, or if you're a dancer, whichever form you learn, but you want to be, you know, be able to take your work further in terms of you know, presentation and performances. And yes, so I feel that is the first thing, because anybody who wants to learn, you know, it's a big high to be able to perform. So I think that is the first, that the immediate ambition of any performer.
And now, when I come to an artist being an entrepreneur and being ambitious and trying to take things ahead, I do understand that lives get changed, because art has the power and the potential to change lives. If you could just elaborate something that you had been telling me just a while back, right, a thing that you are doing right now.
So, along with my acting work and along with Srijan, I have started an NGO called Artscape. The name explains that it is all to do with the performing arts. Because this is a world that I truly know, because I have studied it, I have trained in it, I have performed, so I have gained experience in this. So what I'm doing is using the therapeutic value of these performing art tools for healing. So we all know that music heals, that music makes us feel good. So we are using, along with music, we're using theater-based tools. and we're using movement therapy. That is a process, dance movement therapy is a process that believes, that works on the premise that our mind and body are actually one. All our life experiences and memories are somewhere embedded in our body. So through movement helps you recognize those. It could be good, it could be trauma, but it helps you recognize those memories, those, and then bring it to the fore. And, you know, relive it or get over it, whatever be the situation. So we are working with patients suffering from cancer. We are working with slum children. And I realized that to do this work properly, which will add a lot of value, I've tied up to different NGOs, people who are already working in these fields. So we go to those homes twice, thrice, four times, five times a month, depending on the schedule. We have a proper schedule for the NGO. And we go and do these sessions there. These are properly designed sessions. There are trained facilitators who take this forward. So this is something that, you know, it came to me and I found it giving me a lot of satisfaction. And so this is something that I'm trying to build on and get Artscape on the board.
Tell me something, doesn't it ever, I mean, you have taken it up so much ahead. I mean, you have brought it to this extent. And a lot of it is about your vision. How do you stop yourself from the, I mean, or how do you protect yourself from the self-obsession that often comes in when you are putting in your heart and soul into something and you see the results coming? There is a pride of success.
Definitely, but you know, I think that I work well with the team and I take pride in the fact that, you know, that this is, I don't want to restrict this to just myself. So very early in the, you know, when I was visualizing it, when I was conceptualizing it, I wanted it to be able to reach out to many people. And in order to reach out to the maximum people, it cannot be just me. So I have over the last 2 years built up a team who are as passionate and about the work as I am. So there is no self-obsession there because, you know, I don't want the work to be revolving around me. Yes, I have maybe, you know, spearheaded it. But ultimately, I want Artscape to be like maybe a movement. So we can reach out to many, many more people. Because for all, when I started this work with Artscape, I realized there's many, many, many people, you know, who require this work. Because we are working, broadly speaking, that we are working in the area of mental wellness. Today we are working with cancer patients and with slum children. But it's actually you, me, everybody. You know, we need that help. We are always very particular about our physical needs, our physical welfare, our physical wellness. But we try and mostly, we ignore the bit about mental wellness, mental well-being. It is in that area that Artscape is working.
Absolutely nice talking to you, Kamalikadi. Thank you so much for giving me time. Kamalikadi, I have given her the book just now before coming for this video. So I really hope that you like my book, and even if you don't like, do pass me your feedback. Either I'll be happy or I'll learn. Both ways I gain.
No. I wish you all the very best.
Thank you so much.
The book does really well.
Thank you so much. I really need those wishes. And please do read my book. I really hope everybody will like it. Thank you so much.